Happy Friday. You're joined by me again. Another time. It's summer. It's hot. My name is Zack Fox. This is Bruh on Red Bull Radio. Joining me today, two legendary gentlemen, knee deep in the motherfucking rap game.
Ten toes down. And a finger.
And one pinky finger.
3 points, tens.
The cool kids. What's up, y'all?
Yin Yang twins.
Yin Yang thing.
Yin Yang and
the thing. Is that? That was the most out of pocket thing that you could go up to a microphone and let come out of you.
Or, hey, little mama, let me whisper in your ear. But that bitch was loud, though. You was listening to it on the radio. That shit fucked me up. Yeah. That was the point in time where I'm like, oh, yeah, our life is interdimensional.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, niggas think the simulation, like, started just now.
Nah, it started there. When you heard a whisper louder than a talk.
On the radio.
Louder than a talk.
A talk. That nigga had a tall whisper. Big glass of whisper. Okay.
Oh shit.
Hey, just wear. Hey, protect the Yin Yang twins.
Protect them, bro. They got the best episode of MTV Cribs
ever
of all time.
Yeah, that Red Man one is overrated at this point. You know what I'm saying? Like at one point in time,
that was game changing back then.
Yeah, it didn't appreciate with time. Yeah. But that Yin Yang. That was niggas getting money for the first time in front of your face.
Yeah, that's that type of shit. I like shit that I see that's extravagant, but would make Martin Luther King's stomach hurt.
Yeah. He definitely would have been like,
man, Martin Luther King had plastic on his couches. Niggas. I bet. On everything,
bruh.
I bet.
Bruh.
Martin Luther King, he had plastic on his couches, my nigga.
How many times you think he grabbed his forehead and was like, geez, nigga. Throughout his whole career. Like, niggas probably was doing some crazy dumb shit back then, too. So he probably was.
The wildest thing that Martin Luther King accomplished was having that many niggas that he could trust around him at one time at that age. That's crazy.
Could he really trust them, though?
Yeah, it didn't pan out well.
Not all of them, but a lot of niggas.
That did not pan out well.
It didn't pan out, but
that's a lesson. Like, don't have that many niggas around you when you're standing outside your hotel balcony. Because I just know for a fact, who the fuck, if you get to bussing and I've dropped, and you point your finger at where the shot came from?
It's over there. You
nigga,
a snitch.
Yeah. Off top.
That nigga told.
Hey, since we talk about everything, let's bring that the fuck up.
You think everybody who was there told?
If you get smoked right now, my nigga, ain't no way in fuck I'm going to stand there pointing at where the shots came from. Like, for what? Nigga, you just got smoked. Ghost. First of all, pick me up, bro.
The niggas with him, like,
niggas not even down on his body.
Hey, bro. One of the niggas, like, licked his finger to get the wind direction.
Threw some grass in the air.
I think
a little bit
came from this direction, guys. Nobody move.
Dog, it's a whole bunch of shit about that picture.
Already.
It's like, first of all, cuz, who took the picture?
Right, that was a very well-executed.
Like, what the fuck is going on, bro?
The picture was perfect.
Yeah, fam just got smoked, bro.
The picture looked like a Renaissance.
Jesse Jackson ass got his finger
on his camera,
like,
before
yo,
he even shot
it's
that
from bro. Over there. Jesse Jackson,
the niggas really had an HDR. They had the hood meme filter on the on the MLK
hood
photo.
Meme filter.
I can't
applied.
Believe that Jesse Jackson whole ass ran for president, and not one nigga asked him, "Hey, fam, so when you was on that balcony, you wasn't tripping?
What was going on?
You was just like, oh yeah, they smoked the homie over there.
I knew that was gonna happen. Mm. Probably, yeah.
Jesse with his greasy fingers.
Dog, can we tell you a story about this?
Yes.
But hey, remember, hold on, wait,
hold it,
Jesse
hold
Jackson.
It.
No, because bro, listen, this shit is legendary. We ain't never told him this shit, nobody, bro. So me and this nigga eat some weed ice cream leaving LA. It's like 2008, 2009, right?
Oh my god,
the shit kick in as soon as we get to the American terminal at LAX. We like, damn, this shit going crazy. We can't stop laughing. And me and this nigga, once we start laughing, it's over for everybody. Like, everybody getting roasted, so we can keep this fuel burning. Dog, we get in our seats, and lo and behold, this nigga Jesse Jackson.
Shut the fuck up, bro.
Are we? Am I lying, bro?
Bro, some ladies like escorted him to the front of the line and shit. I'm like, who's this nigga getting to cut everybody? And everybody like, it's Jesse Jackson.
I don't give a fuck.
Bro, I was like, fuck Jesse Jackson, man. So he get to the front, and you know he got his little smug look, and he get in, you know.
He definitely gave us the pull your pants up, little niggas look in our eyes, and I had sweatpants on, so I ain't never know.
Nuggles. Nuggles, pull them up. You're embarrassing me in front of all these fine employees of American Airlines.
So I don't respect Jesse. I'll slap the shit out of that.
Hey, but look, let me get to the point, bro. What I'm about to tell you is not what you have no clue where this story goes.
Okay, wait. Let's hold the punch because it's a perfect topic. Let's get into some music.
All right.
And then we're going to come back. And then we're going to hear the climax to Chuck's Jesse Jackson story.
No, this me and this nigga are sitting next to each other on the plane. This is a cool kid story.
Okay, this is perfect.
And he is the culprit. What he did is what fucking happened.
Okay. Let's get into it. We'll be back. Red Bull Radio. This is bro. We'll be back. Yurt! And we are back. Red Bull Radio. This is bro. You just heard some music. Like I said, I'm sitting here with the cool kids. It's the goddamn heat of summer. My armpit sweating. It's Friday. When we left, Chuck was in the middle of a very climactic story about being on a plane with Jesse Jackson.
Yeah, let me run it back, but let me give you the bridge version. So basically, we eat weed ice cream. This is like when edibles is, you know, at his teenage phase. These gentrified edibles.
The adolescent.
Was at their teenage phase. You come to L.A., you eat.
Going
like,
brazy.
Yeah, weed ice cream. We had the strawberry shit. We had one apiece. We went crazy with it. Got to the gate. We standing in the line, like you said. Mm-hmm. A tall, shadowy man gets ushered to the front. Mm. It happens to be Jesse Jackson. Nigga looks at us crazy. So we was on it with him off rip. Like, man, why you know what I'm saying? Like, I had no smoke for Jesse Jackson. I grew up in Detroit, but I live in Chicago. Only motherfuckers from Chicago is like, yo, Jesse Jackson, fuck that nigga. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, he always looked like a wet groundhog. Like, he's always greasy. His mustache was just always looking like his crumbs of chicken and just debris in that bitch. Like, he wasn't never cool in Chicago, man, but continue.
All right, dog.
Nigga Jesse Jackson built Picasso.
This is after he went crazy on Obama, right? But was crying in Grant Park when Obama won. So he was just like, oh, you a hypocrite, nigga. Like,
whoa.
Biting his lip and shit. Man. Yeah.
So, all right, let's fast forward. So we feel slighted. We get to our seat. Jesse Jackson sits in front of me. We looking at the back of this ball spot. We high as fuck. This nigga, Mikey, like, I'm gonna touch it.
Did you Michael Jordan the back of his head?
He was sitting right in front of me, bro. He was sitting right in front of me. That bitch looked like when you first seen an iPad for the first time. You just like, damn, I just wanna DJ on that bitch or something, bro. I was looking at that motherfucker like, whoa. It was just like devoid of all hair and just any follicles. It was just so smooth and just glassy.
Shit look like you can bring something up on it. Like, you can swipe up on that motherfucker.
Right. It looked like you could damn near watch a movie. It looked like some shit was going on. So I'm like, damn, I'm about to touch it. I'm high as fuck, bro. I'm only like, it's like pre-21. I'm just super blazed, bro.
Hey, so look, like, hold on. I low-key bet him. I bet him, but it backfired. I'm like, you ain't gonna touch it. He like, nigga, actually, I'm right there. So, look, as we definitely not convinced to do it, right? It's a little too far away. Then Jesse Jackson pulls this elitist ass. I'm gonna leave my seat back before we take off shit. So I'm like, oh, it's game time. This nigga Mikey looks at it. I'm like, it's right there. He go, he tapped that bitch so slow, dog. And I saw the little piece of hair move, and I couldn't stop. I cried laughing on the plane. Whole 4-hour flight, bro. I couldn't handle it.
Dog, did he even flinch, though?
No, the nigga didn't even move.
You didn't feel it?
I don't think he even got nerves in the top of his head nigga's head,
that Westworld ass nigga.
I don't even think he got, like, nerve follicles and shit no more in his head after all the years of just being that ball, bro. Like,
nigga's been slapping that nigga in the back of the head.
He don't feel that shit no more at this point, so
shut your ass up. Just,
hey, if we would have, if anybody would have, hey, that would have been the most.
Wow.
You could have just gave him a palm. Yeah, that would have been overkill. He probably would have.
If you had a Michael Jordan, Jesse Jackson head.
I wonder what he would have did. I wonder what he would have hit a child, you know? hit a young man in the airplane in front
of
everybody.
That's like a goddamn civil rights draw war card. Like, we get to bring back some other niggas from the dead after you do that type shit. Like, I just sunned him so hard.
Right, you get to like
we get four niggas back.
Yeah, yeah, it's like touching the Space Jam ball. Oh, like yeah. We get like suck his powers out.
Cars and shit out of this, man. Yeah.
Oh
bro.
My god.
Wow.
Yeah. I ain't never told that story before.
That is
damn. No, that brought back memories. That was a good one, man.
That's
I was
fucking amazing.
But yeah, off the edibles too. When the edible kicks in like a motherfucker, that's basically like when the edible kicks in.
And if it's the old shit that you're talking about, then it's
the
like
old shit. It was homemade.
They could take out a cult, like Jim Jones edibles.
Yeah, how do we start? Oh yeah, we started it because Jesse Jackson was pointing his finger after Martin Luther King got killed. If I get smoked and you in the picture, I'm coming back to haunt you, my nigga. Like
I'm like somebody.
You was never my friend. Like if you ain't take off and then come back to get me later, I'm not gonna trust it.
Last thing I'm doing is pointing after some shots. I don't even care where it came from. I'm just about to get out the jam. Like it's over with.
That's it.
Yeah, it's over for that.
The best plane story that I have so far. I didn't start seeing like important people on planes until like this year, and like 2 weeks ago I was on a plane, and I was in coach as fuck.
Super
and
coach.
Like I look in the emergency.
21B.
Oh yes, nigga. Like 32.
21B is the worst.
I was going to Ohio.
21B is the worst seat you can ever have on a plane.
Coming back,
it's the middle.
Going to Atlanta actually. I look at the fucking emergency exit seat, and on the window, on the door, is Black China. This is just a few weeks ago.
Oh, damn. So this is new Black China.
This is new Black China in like an Adidas tracksuit. And, you know, I was drunk
too.
And I was thinking like, man, if the shit goes down, all of our lives are in Black China's hands.
Oh, yeah, baby. Let's get it.
Let's do a music break.
Alright, and then we got a new song we want to play on this.
Let's do it.
We made a song called Bitcoin in the Strip Club.
I'm like so ready to hear this shit. You have no fucking idea.
I wanted to debut it here. We had it, got it mixed and mastered today.
World premiere.
It's actually out today.
Oh, perfect. Yeah. Let's get it. Alright, we'll do some music. We're gonna listen to some new cool kids, and we'll be back. Bruh, stay tuned. And we're back with the cool kids on Bruh. This is Red Bull Radio. I'm Zach Fox with Sir Michael Rocks and Chuck. And when we left, you know, man, you know, we be on Twitter a lot, whether it's quietly or loudly.
I think between all three of us,
we be on tweets, that motherfucker.
Our tweets are balancing the world out.
Absolutely.
I think collectively, we got about two.
Yeah, the pH balance is good.
We got about two serious tweets per person in out of 10,000 tweets.
Yes.
I'll retweet some shit that's fucked up in the world, but I'm not giving my opinion on it. I'm just like, nigga, this shit's fucked up. Here you go.
You know, with all the shit that we see, cancel culture is at its height right now.
Oh, yeah.
And whether you like it or not, you got to look at it and say it's a reality. Anything is getting canceled. Anything walking. So instead of hating that shit, I think that we should just cash in.
And cancel some
and
shit.
And cancel some shit right here.
Yeah, let's establish this.
Okay, so check this out. This is probably going to get me fried. R. Kelly.
Oh, yeah, get that nigga the fuck up out of here.
All right, the nigga, but are we done playing?
The nigga,
are we done playing the songs?
The nigga, but
I don't care about
the
man.
Step in the name of love canceled? That's what I'm saying. It's step in the name of love canceled, my nigga.
I think I'm done. I think I'm over.
Yeah,
we
low-key
can't we play AJ Nothing But a Number?
Oh, that's really canceled. Yeah, that was the first one that had to be canceled.
That shit was weird. And we've been pumping. See, my whole theory is,
what if somebody make like a reggae cover of Step in the Name of Love? Is that still supporting Kells?
I'm asking you, you can't listen to.
I think you got to just cancel the whole.
I think
individual.
It's all
world
gone,
great.
Yeah.
The world's greatest. I believe I could fly. It's over.
It's gone. We need to just put I Believe I Could Fly in the same
so
category as like
Trey
the KKK
songs?
Theme song.
Damn, yeah. The KKK theme song and costume.
Stand up but and look. Be counted. Join up the USA.
Check this out.
Yeah.
It's nigga, when R. Kelly and Jay-Z put out Best of Both Worlds, they tried to cancel shit then, right? We knew all this shit then.
Yeah.
2001. I ain't even in college yet. We knew all this shit. You know what I'm saying? It's 2018, and niggas is acting like this nigga R. Kelly has done something different in 18 years. Everybody, so just because we in 2018, And niggas is on the internet like, oh yes, fuck R. Kelly. Like, why wasn't it fuck R. Kelly in 2005 when he made the Double Up album? We could have got cuz out of there right then with them two big ass bug eye glasses when he did the Double Up album.
With his illiterate
with Bow Wow, I'm a Flirt. We could have got cuz out of there right then.
Why did we let a nigga that can't read get it that far first off? I know he can't read or write. It's not a myth.
We were just easier on people.
I think we just looking for a hero at that point, man. We just looking for somebody to do something.
All I'm asking is, niggas knew R. Kelly was on this much trash, why'd they put him in so many important musical like sections of life? Like the Muhammad Ali movie, let's get R. Kelly to sing the fucking song.
Right.
Bitch, you knew R. Kelly was already doing weird shit. Now we in 2018 and nigga half my DJ set I gotta throw out.
Yeah.
I'm fucking hot.
My memories of Space Jam forever tainted.
If it be different, it's like the Cosby shit where I'm newly pissed. Like, nigga, what?
Nigga,
Cosby, you bitch ass nigga.
Just like, let's just go re-release Space Jam with a Future song at the end.
Nah. Just switch them out.
Because then it's going to start coming off like that Superfly movie, and I'm scared as fuck of that shit.
That looks trash.
What's happening with that? He's like the curator or something of this?
Yeah, he's the Curtis Mayfield of the motherfucking...
Future should not be the Curtis
Future
Mayfield.
Future Hendrix.
It's
curating and...
All right, so I'm comfortable with...
I want Future to be the curator of like Pacific Rim or like a big Godzilla comeback, because that like his music feels larger than life, like shit getting fucked up. Not like Frank Lucas type shit.
All right, so R. Kelly, you officially canceled, my nigga. And if it gets to us and we got to give up on you, it's gotten all
bad. Hey, if I see that nigga R. Kelly in public,
we're gonna hit that nigga in the head with a shovel.
We're
gonna let go of folks, man. We're gonna let go of him.
Yeah,
it's about time, man.
Niggas getting hit in the head with a shovel right now.
Just off the Chicago folklore alone, we should have.
He got a huge folklore.
We should have been. Oh yeah, let's talk about it because that shit ain't been brought up. Now that we gotten them out of here, let's bring up the Chicago folklore.
Oh yeah, I got the dark.
Oh yeah, we got the shit. We got the news nobody else got.
So check this out.
Let's start off with the basketball games.
Peep game. So R. Kelly goes to various downtown gyms to play basketball with him and his security guards, and then they just run random 5-on-5s with any random niggas in the gym. So when R. Kelly plays basketball, what happens is he has his four security guards foul everybody on the court and take the ball and pass it to him in the best spot where he could shoot a three. They don't fucking really dribble. They don't dunk. They don't pass. They don't shoot on their own.
They just give it to
Kels. They just make sure that you're fouled and they're going to give the ball to Kels. And he going to shoot a three on your ass and act like it's
like his.
Pretty cool. Yeah. And if you touch him and foul him, he'll damn near fight you on the court too. Like, this is a known fact about R. Kelly in Chicago downtown gym.
Okay,
like,
this is an accepted bitch nigga attribute.
He drive his tour bus to the gym. You feel me? Like, he goes to the gym in a tour bus. Then he hop out with the security guards.
Wow.
And he like, who want it? And then he get on the court and they beat your ass for about 40 minutes. And then R. Kelly shoots some threes.
Wow.
That's about it.
Wow. What else we canceling right here on Bruh?
Oh, yeah. We had R. Kells. We had...
Sis. White girl saying sis.
Oh yeah. We're going to throw that out the window.
Get that shit the fuck up out of here.
We're not going to do that no more.
No, we can't do that.
Stop.
What was the one about brunch?
Oh, brunching.
What did we decide brunching really was in reality?
Oh, yeah.
Brunch is just like Rolling Loud for niggas over 40 who just got their shit together, so they think they're doing something that's
niggas
like
that,
really different and
niggas
special.
Niggas that were
really different.
Niggas that took their shirt in now.
It's mimosas. It's mimosas.
Niggas
it's
that
mimosas,
wear suit jackets with their casual fits now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's mimosas.
Niggas who got like enough morale back into their life to go to a tech school. But like way too late, and like
niggas that get their niggas that get their beard lined up at the neckline,
with
their extra neck underneath.
Exactly.
Let's go.
It's the same type of person who is really emphatic about like Rick Ross and 2 Chainz. That's like that.
All I want to say, if any of the big homies is out there, if you got hella neck and it's beard hair that grow there, stop letting the barber line you up at your neck, nigga. You look goofy as hell. It looked like you got a seatbelt on your face.
Oh shit! Damn, are we canceling? Are we canceling barbers?
Let's go to the barbershop.
Are we canceling barbers that spray that black shit on your head when you didn't ask for it?
Yes, dog.
They gotta go because it's like you're gonna get me fucking killed, bro.
Yeah.
The fuck are you doing?
They don't even
Did
ask.
I tell you?
It's
like, nigga,
I'm like, never spray that shit on me like that, boy. A nigga did that to me before. I lost it, bro. I was like, dude,
fibers, you cut on
the sink. Cut the sink on and wash this shit off my head, bro.
Steve Harvey juice.
If I go out here into these streets,
some Steve Harvey juice on my head.
I'm like, no, somebody see me with
that
shit?
Different. This, that's different. They got the super fibers. Secret fibers now.
He damn near grab a club flyer and then put that shit on your lining and then spray it around your lining until your shit look like a Lego cap, nigga. Like
some shit that say Sloppy Tuesdays. You like, nigga, if you don't get this shit off my head.
He hold it up to your forehead and go,
nah, that nigga always put his business card up.
Oh, yeah. You know he put his business card up. Licensed barber.
Hey, because we got Instagram barbers nowadays.
Ah, this is true. You
know what I'm saying? Oh, man.
I ran into
one in London, and I hope he's listening because I hate him. I hate you, bro. I hate you, man.
London? What was you doing in London trying to get your hair cut, though?
Fuck if I know. I just had to try
it. You
gotta
go to the ends. You gotta go to where the Nigerians is.
He came through and he was a celebrity Instagram barber.
Was he Nigerian?
Nope. I don't know what he was, man. He wasn't Nigerian, though.
I don't trust no nigga in London cutting my hair unless he first generation.
Yeah, West Indies.
Nigerian.
West Indian or Nigerian niggas, bro. You can't get your hair cut in London by nobody else. No Craig David ass nigga gonna fade me up.
Nah. He I don't even know what kind of nigga this was.
I promise you. And I ain't even into colorism, but nigga.
Colorism.
I don't even, you know what I'm saying? And sexism too, because it's not too many. Like, I done let a couple girls give me a fade, and I was like, bitch, I don't trust you.
I trust a black woman from America before I trust.
No, that's what I meant. I'm not. I was talking about London. Like a lighter, fair skinned, racially ambiguous woman with the lineup clippers. I'm not going.
Remember I let that Australian old man give me a line in that time.
And boy, he was shit, so pissed.
He had my shit looking crikey. Like a rainbow, boy. It's like,
hey,
I'm like, why didn't you just draw the line straight across? Why'd you do an arch like this is fucking Batman signal or something?
I don't trust no nigga cutting my hair that got to check his shoes for scorpions in the morning.
Yeah, he got to check for black mambas
anxious.
And shit.
You are anxious as shit. Let's go to a break. We'll come back. We're gonna talk more with the cool kids. We're gonna cancel some more shit probably and be more problematic. I'm Zach Fox. This is Bruh. We'll be back. And we're back. This is Bruh. Having a great time here with the cool kids. Zach Fox, presented to you by Awful Records and Rebel Radio. I don't know if I already said that. Before we left, man, we was talking about, man, just old weird niggas, man. Just old weird niggas. I think that a big part of, like, why...
Bro, T.D. Jakes wears me out.
T.D. Jakes... I feel like there's something right there just waiting to come out.
I feel like he feels like that monkey from Jungle Book.
I feel like that nigga drink blood or something. I'm gonna just come out with it.
Drinks blood.
Yeah, it's something off.
He wanted them adrenochrome niggas, but like,
oh man.
Who is that?
Adrenochrome?
Yeah, what's that?
It's like this like crazy fluid in like infant spinal cords that these like crazy Illuminati old white men like try to get access to.
Oh,
I'm not kidding.
Baby
this is a huge
spinal
theory.
Cord juices.
I'm serious. It's
that shit
like,
makes sense. These niggas weird like that.
Yeah, they need that.
Did you see the shit on internet about the rabbi baptizing the baby and dunked this nigga in the water like like yo, cuz is already
nigga got baptized with a B emoji.
We
like,
gotta go look in 15 years. In 15 years, we gotta remember this and go back and try to find that. No matter what we doing in the career, I'm pretty sure that'd be an ill content piece. Go find that baby that was dunked three times
and see what his life is like.
Just how the fuck that shit turned out. I don't see it going too well. I'm pretty sure like God was like, oh yeah, you baptized. I think you did a little bit too hard. You gotta send cuz back. I can't do anything.
It's
like breaking a phone and then sending it over to God. He's like, yeah.
Or this nigga's so blessed with like a big ass old English B. Blessed.
Blessed, bitch.
Yeah, that his shit just
Buku
his
blessed.
Shit turned out so well.
Alright. So yeah, Oh, weird shit. Back to that. Cause we gotta finish that discussion. That shit was crazy.
Yeah, we was talking about, you know, like regular, like beautiful women who have their lives together wouldn't ever really get with any of these Hollywood niggas. And that's why I know all of them are like on some fuck shit. Because, like, for instance, like this nigga Leonardo DiCaprio. This is publicized information, so I'm not giving some goddamn shade room shit here. But a lot of people didn't see it that this nigga be wearing earbuds when he has sex with women.
But tell the song that was told.
The specific song.
Soundtrack. What is it?
Was MGMT Electric Feel.
Now.
With earbuds.
Yo, my man is a method actor. My nigga slept in a bear. You not gonna let him cook?
I'm not gonna
let
him.
Did he have the earbuds, the wireless ones?
I think this is probably wireless.
This is probably a cord on them bitches.
If it had a cord,
it was a cord on them bitches. For sure.
If you got the wireless joints, though, if you got the wireless joints, it's like that episode of Black. It's that episode of Black Mirror.
Which
remember the one where they was putting on the head to feel each other's emotions?
Oh,
and shit.
Okay.
Maybe he was putting the headphones in so he could drill. He's like, he was on the drill mission. Like,
but it also specified that he was just laying there.
Man, nigga.
Just listening. Was he on drugs, maybe?
Possibly.
Who knows? It's old news. I don't know if he still do that shit.
If I was off a whole bunch of pure ass Leonardo DiCaprio Molly, my nigga, I'm putting my earbuds in and none of y'all better say shit to me.
Why you don't just play it off your phone or Bluetooth?
Fuck, I don't know this bitch like that. I'm off.
You're not
going
to find a lot of just like in their right mind women who are going to like be like, yeah, I'll sign up for that. Like some weird shit like that.
Hey, but let's talk about this. Because we got to pack a lot into a little. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like we all got the same ideals. What bag is Arby's pulling from? Like, why? How does Arby's got so much money? They low-key got more money than Red Bull. They got commercial. Hey, do you know a nigga that's been to Arby's?
Listen, I think that Arby's is a very elaborate laundering scheme.
I was about to, it's a front.
For some really weird shit that we're going to find out down the line.
That shit been desolate looking. That shit been looking like Fortnite since I was
nigga.
Third grade, bro.
I can never go, seen like, more always than three empty. People in Arby's.
You it's can go empty. Into an Arby's and hear flies fuck. I've never seen anyone
The electricity
in there.
Barely be running in every Arby's. It's barely electricity in that bitch.
They got Ving Rhames doing the commercials. Niggas, they got a new sandwich every motherfucking week.
Them niggas selling bagels with lunch meat.
Hey, they just bought Buffalo Wild Wings for $2.7 billion.
Arby's did. Yes. Oh, yeah, there's something going on. There's
who's keeping
on.
Who keeping them in business? Who's keeping this bag for Arby's? Like, what's their demographic?
No, it's an Arby's. Arby's
on Hollywood.
It's an Arby's. I never seen a nigga in that bitch.
Because they don't. It's like Arby's don't even want you to go in that.
They don't even got the new sign.
Exactly.
They don't even got the new sign on the one in Hollywood.
They're not trying to get anyone into an Arby's.
They're like, we got commercials.
And we
got to
shake this shit up. Just like Hannibal shook the Cosby Show shit.
Yep.
Nigga, we on Arby's.
What's up with Arby's? Expose Arby's.
Let's start seeing some tax records or something. Because I don't think you motherfuckers is really doing what you're saying, man.
Get them niggas the fuck out here so they could tell us what's going on.
Hey, look, have you ever had Arby's curly fries? Sandwiches.
Nigga, I ain't tasted nothing from Arby's since I was a kid. Like a little one.
Yeah, and even then, I was sad. Like, I was sad going to Arby's as a kid.
I had to be in there because somebody older and dumber than me took me there.
They put cheese sauce on their shit. They got roast beef with cheese sauce, my nigga.
Yes, melted cheese sauce.
They not even selling
like out of a gun.
And if
you
ever seen that roast beef, it really looked like niggas filed human skin down and put little
filed.
You know what I'm saying? We exposing everything. We got a short clock. What else we exposing?
Because
I had to bring Arby's to the digital airspace. Like, nigga, y'all got me fucked up. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's hella money missing out here. And people going through shit. And
people,
Arby's,
all these
Arby's
people
got Arby's new locations.
Here,
right,
listen.
Arby's got
Here's
new locations,
I think it is.
Bro.
All these niggas going missing all over the United States.
Did Arby's make a mixtape last year?
Arby's employing the motherfuckers. I bet we can go in any Arby's and find somebody who missing in another state.
They working at Arby's.
They working at Arby's.
Not
and they
underneath
put them there,
their own control.
And they put them there because nobody goes into Arby's.
You never see that motherfucker again. Yeah.
Hey,
last
you,
place you'll look
peep?
Is Arby's because exactly. nobody
hey,
goes
did
there.
Did you peep that Wendy's had a mixtape and then they had a Don C clothing line?
The fuck? Like oh, Hamburger
Wendy's
Helper?
Did have a mixtape and they dissed a lot of niggas on there too. So.
And they had a Don C clothing line.
What?
Bro, this shit is real.
Wendy's had a mixtape?
Yeah.
Posted by Post Malone.
We beefing.
He said we beefing.
That was the title, I believe. We beefing.
And they had
so
a
they came out like 50.
Nigga, yeah, they came out
they
swinging
had Don
on
C
all
jerseys
other
and shorts,
and
bro.
First off, fuck Burger King in the bitch. You like?
Yeah. Just like that. I'm dead ass.
And then
stole just
your
like
fry
that.
Recipe.
And
then fat did you see? Did you see Taco Bell coming with the Illuminati commercials?
What?
The Belluminati? Yeah, I saw.
Bro, you know,
oh, I have
they doing
seen
all
this.
Type of Eyes Wide Shut commercials and shit. They weird, man.
Okay, so here's what I think. Whoever runs Arby's is paying them niggas to do weird shit like that,
yeah,
to take
them
attention.
Off they back.
Hey, we gotta figure out who runs Arby's. Man, I wish it was Boondocks. Oh, like, I wish the Boondocks was out, because they would have definitely.
Where is Aaron McGruder?
They might have covered it.
Yeah, I want to know what that nigga thinks about Arby's. I think Arby's is on that Boondocks BET shit.
Whoa, this is weird, man. This is creeping me out.
They probably haven't made
Let's
a
do
profit. They probably haven't made a profit in 20 years, bro. Like,
me and
Arby's?
Me and the cool
a
kids.
A profit?
About to do an HBO expose.
Thanks.
I'm
curious to see
to
and
Arby's
figure
who's
giving
them money,
bro.
Yeah.
Who giving them money, man? Like,
I feel like motherfuckers that pull up to Cracker Barrel don't even be like, yeah, nah, Arby's is trash.
Bro, I will go to Cracker Barrel
before I go to
Arby's.
Yo, I feel like motherfuckers that go to Jollibee
and Cracker Barrel smell
Jollibee.
Like
Jollibee is the feds, too. Because I know, you know, the Filipinos homies, oh, yeah, Jollibee. But like, nigga,
right.
Nah, I ain't going. That shit is
Hell
crazy.
Nah.
Like, I know y'all like y'all shit. And I, you know, I love Filipino food, like crack an egg over the rice with the spam. That shit is good as fuck. But nigga, I'm not going in a Jollibee, fam.
Nah.
That shit is, what is it? And then y'all got that weird ass ice cream. Nah. How is y'all open?
Dog food.
Yeah, and then what about, what's the Yoshinoya beef?
Yoshinoya is trash.
It's 50 of those on every LA block, bro. Like,
how?
Bro.
It just looked like you about to just.
Where are they getting they beef from?
Intestines out as soon as you eat that.
I'm gonna go in there just windmill swinging punches.
So what do they specialize in? Just bowls of just what?
Nigga, cat food.
Teriyaki and cats foods and shit. And
nigga,
here, take it.
That shit look like
take
meow mix.
Shit.
Yo. Yeah. What is
Fancy Feast. That it look like Fancy
it look
Feast.
Like Fancy
or
Feast.
The fancy cat food that come in that little fancy can and
nigga
you peel it off.
That bitch open and just.
Fancy cap.
Hey, had to hit the back with a spoon.
Hey, but look, is it really quiet for McDonald's? Because I was thinking about McDonald's for such a long time about how oddly, pandering the commercials used to be. Mm. Do you remember the nigga that was singing the R&B song with the chicken nuggets in the rain like Ray J?
Yeah, they really wanted black people in McDonald's.
Get
yeah.
your ass over to McDonald's and grab some
really
of these nuggets, nigga. Like,
they got a new one with like a black shit. Dad and his son like in a suit and he's about to like go off to college or some weird shit
yeah,
like
so
that.
Yeah, so definitely
like,
go to McDonald's.
Y'all really want niggas up in there? Okay. That's
niggas going to the Waffle House. Still.
Still, I'm going to the
niggas
Waffle
got
House.
Smoked
I'm sorry.
In the Waffle
they
House.
They best at the Waffle House.
Hey, sorry. Not,
the Waffle
one,
House.
Not one person brought.
I'm pulling up in a bomb-proof Cadillac Escalade.
Hey, the Waffle House like the post office, but niggas still got to go in that bitch.
No, the employees be boxing. Any patrons and customers be shooting. It's buck. Yeah.
I remember that Travis
Waffle
Porter
House
song. Welcome to the Waffle House. 20 saucy biscuit. Hey, excuse me, man. Welcome on the saucy biscuit.
They don't know shit about that. We playing that on
man.
This episode
yeah,
of Red Bull Radio. Oh, bro. And we're back. So you guys want to get into this song that we about to drop?
Yeah, let's introduce that.
This is about to be a legendary.
Yeah, man. This moment. Is we you know the first release since our last full length album.
Mm-hmm.
We taking you know dropping little songs here and there throughout the year.
Mm-hmm.
And then probably towards the end of the year, get to working on the next one. I feel like the last one, people were like, oh, they're back together. All right, cool. But they didn't even check it out. So we just like, all right, let's turn it up a little bit. Like, let's go with some subjects that's actually what we talk about. Because I feel like when we make music sometimes, I go for what the song feels like. Before this, I was just playing them beats. He was like, man, this shit got a crazy-ass bounce. And I remember reading this article. Mm-hmm. About this strip club that was taking Bitcoin. I'm like, oh, it's motherfucking woke
yeah.
now. Like,
everything's here.
Yeah, we woke
the
now.
The future is here.
The strip club is woke. We got
QR codes and shit.
Yeah, it's Bitcoin in the strip club. So,
wow.
The name of the song is called Ripple.
Okay.
Because it sound like booty meat shaking.
Cool. Thank y'all. We'll see you next time. Next episode. Jesus. Oh my God.
We'll be back.
If I still got a show, we'll see you next time on Bruh, presented by Alpha Records. It's Rebel Radio. Peace.